Time flies. I can't believe I've been there 15 years ago already. And they had just started, Marciano and Christina, and been good friends since I was Anna's age. So 4 years old is when he started. Marciano, he started being a part of my life and my family's life in Brazil. And then when he went to the fields for the first time, and met his wife in Hawaii, of all places, and they both had the call to go to Africa, and God continued to shape and lead and mold them, and they started there. And so today I have the privilege to have him with us. He's visiting. I've mentioned them before in previous sermons, how they've been really role models for me, and kind of seeing a family who has decided to live on fire, sold out for Christ. And he's here with Christina. Christina's in the back right there, Christina. And Marciano is going to share the word. He's going to preach today. So would you welcome Marciano this morning?
Good morning, everybody. It's such a joy to be here with you this morning. It's great to see Leandro again, Isabella, the children, and this beautiful part of the body of Christ. Let's pray together. Father, thank you for the first and great miracle, that is the salvation that you have provided to us through the sacrifice of your Son on the cross. Thank you, Lord, for one day having mercy on us and calling us from the darkness to the light. And pray that you lead us this morning as we open our Bible to share your word together. Be with us, feed us, bless us. In the name of Jesus. Amen. As Leandro presented, as Christina, my wife, we have two boys. It's Caleb and Emmanuel. When we moved to Ethiopia, Emmanuel was 1 year old, and Christina was pregnant of 6 months from the Caleb, a very courageous lady that God has given to us. So we moved to Ethiopia, but the whole thing on Ethiopia, I want to share a bit with you on that. It started one day I was in my home watching a documentary about the famine in Ethiopia. Probably some of you have seen. And it was a disaster. Many people died of hunger. And I asked God, God, why does somebody must die because they have no bread to eat? And it was me and God and watching that documentary on the TV. And I understood God speaking back to me. I asked God, why doesn't somebody do something? And understood God saying, why don't you do something about it? And I said, but who am I? I'm just here, Brazilian, far away from Ethiopia, and I'm just eating rice and beans. I have nothing to do, to give, to offer. Then understood God saying, here we go, you have rice and beans. Give you rice and eat your beans. And from that moment, from that conversation, I was sure God was calling me as a missionary to Ethiopia, and then begin a tremendous adventure for my life. Let's open our Bibles in Isaiah 54. That day was the day when God began to speak to me, move on, move on. Expand your horizon. Expand your views of me as your God, and the view of yourself, and the view of the possibilities. And that is something I would like to share with you this morning. There in Isaiah 54, the verse 2, it says, enlarge the place of your tent and stretch your tent curtains wide. Do not hold back. Lengthen your cords and strengthen your stakes. It's a calling from God. A calling for a vision, a calling for a dream, a calling for us to probably to move from our comfort zone, a calling to create something, to start developing in us something new, something different. And I believe that everything that is created, that is done, it started with a little seed here in our hearts. Somebody must dream about it. Somebody one day dreamed about this building, about this church. Somebody one day dreamed about these pictures or dreamed. Somebody one day had it first being born here in their hearts. And from that vision in their hearts, it begin to go to their mind and to a paper and to a calling. Let's do it. And I believe God calls us daily for new dreams. What do you dream? What is our dream today? What is our wishes? And I believe God challenges us to stretch, to expand our horizons. Sometimes we arrive in a place and we accomplish our status quo and we are satisfied by where we are and what we are doing. And it was me there sitting in my TV, comfortable, watching television. And God said, come on, Marcian, is that enough for you? I had 2 years that I had given my life to the Lord. And that day, God stretched it, God enlarged it. My visions and my ways of seeing Him. We need to ask God to give us power and grace to do the things that we wish to do and we have difficulties to do. Have you ever seen that situation? Oh, I wish I could. We have sometimes people come into our projects and they cry and they said, oh, I wish I could do that. You know, we wish and sometimes we don't have grace and power to move on. And I believe we can also pray to God, God, I want to do. I wish I could do something. I wish I could stretch the place where I work. I stretch the situation of my housing or my family or my children or my career or my relationships or my studies. God, I wish I could expand, stretch it, but I have no power to go on. God, give me power to accomplish, to move in the things that I still am scared or that I still have difficulty. So not only this journey to Ethiopia, but 4 years ago, as we did in Ethiopia, we lived 7 years in Ethiopia and 7 years in Brazil. I believe God was calling also to open the project in another part of the world. I went to India, to Kolkata, and then in Kolkata, I came thinking, well, after 4 years or so, I will come here to Kolkata, to India, to start a project. And then walking there on the streets of Kolkata, God challenged me, say, Marciano, you seem a bit selfish. Look, there is a need now here. Why are you waiting 3 years, 4 years to come? And there walking on the streets, I met people living on the streets. Was not that they were there on the street. They lived on the streets. They wake up. This is the place where the children keep their school material. Their house is there on the sidewalk on the street. They wake up. They sleep. They live there on the streets every day. And seeing there those people in the streets, I felt God challenged me, Marciano, come on. Have the courage. Stretch your possibilities. We found Indian staff. We hired them. We begin registering the children there on the street. We registered the project. We found the place. And now the project also runs there in India, in Kolkata. This is first was a crowd of children in Kolkata. Now those are in Ethiopia. And then our group of children in Brazil. So we are running in India, Ethiopia, and Brazil. It is possible to stretch and to accept the challenge that God has for us every day. And I was thinking, are we open? Are we ready to accept those challenges? Enlarge the place of your things. Stretch it. Where you are today. Where you are today. I remember also, remember the multiplication of the bread. Remember, was more than 5,000 people there. A crowd. And a little young boy there with some bread and some fish, and this crowd, this hunger crowd there waiting something together. This little boy, he came out of the crowd, probably poor. It's not enough for such a huge number of people. You know, but he had the courage to go to the front and to offer the little thing he had. He looked at the resources he had in his hand in that moment, and he said, here we go. I don't have much. The crowd is so big. The need is so big. But it's here available for what God wants to do with that. And for me, that was a great example of stretching his world, his possibility. He said, I have nothing. I have just a few fish and a few bread, but something must happen with that. It's possible that something may happen with those things. So I believe God called us for jumping an adventure with him. There in Ethiopia, we started with only 4 children. We arrived there. We didn't start the project with a great, huge budget. We had no money. We start from our house. Christina opened the window door from the kitchen, and she would give bread to 4 children that would come every day. And from these 4 children, went into 10. From 10 children, went into 20. So, oops, our house is too small now for this. We put them, our children's clothes, we fed them with our food, we washed them with our water, and God said, well, this is the moment we start something there. But it started very small. It started with 4 children. And now we are more than 1,000 children around the world. More than 1,000 children. What do you have in your hands today? What are the resources you have in your hands today? Stretch, enlarge. But it's not enough, I believe, just stretching, but persevere in what God is calling you to do. What is the vision? What is the dreams that God is calling you to do? Persevere. Stay there. Put your feet on the door. Don't give up. Take away this word from your vocabulary, giving up. For me, as a no, I have to hear a no 10 times before I believe is a no. We had people from some of those governments telling us, okay, we can put you out of this country in 24 hours. I said, okay, do it. They say, okay, they're telling us, so you give us the money and we run the project. I say, no way, Jose. If I give you the money, I know what happened. And that guy told me, I will throw you, I have the power to throw you out of the country in 24 hours. I say, really? Okay, are you threatening me? Go do it. No, okay, relax. Let's keep talking. This guy, 2 years later, was in prison for corruption. And the project running. The children being blessed. You know? In Brazil, we had a lawyer that came and challenged me. He said, you will not do. We will not allow it to do. And, you know, and then 2 years later, we were running the project. We had our Christmas celebration. And I went to the mayor to invite him for the celebration. Who I see there? The lawyer that opposed me strongly, that didn't want to allow. I gave invitation to him. No, we are celebrating Christmas in our project. Come there and say hello to our children. Yeah. Say, yes, the project that you want, you know, stop is happening now. And the children is being blessed. So persevere. Don't allow that. Things say no to you. Don't accept a no. Amen? We were there right at the time when I was there with my wife and 2 children. Our seat was bombed. You know, we are there on the place of war, Ethiopia and Eritrea, and you are there and you hear a bomb coming down. You see the aeroplane and you hear a bomb coming down. That is a few scary minutes. The bomb is falling into your seat and you don't know if it fall in your house or not. And you, your family is there. And suddenly the bomb, it falls down there in another place. And unfortunately, it killed many people. And probably that's the time and say, whoa, time to go. And it's time to stay. It's time to affirm that we are here to be salt, to be light, to be blessing. We had our child, he almost died. Almost we lost. I drove to the hospital with my son already with the lips blue and no signs of life. And we say, God, we are losing our children. We are losing my child. But he didn't die and save it. And the great big question from God was, Marcian, would you stay even if he had died? You know, so there will be enough situations that will pull you back. So don't give up. Persevere in what God called you to do. Your vision is your vision. It's nobody else's vision. God put in your heart for you to carry on, for you to move on with that. If somebody has to persevere, it's you. Don't move back. Don't go back, not even to take impulse to go to the front again. Don't go to the front. Yeah. Imagine that boy there and how many people among the crowd will tell him, come on, boy, you have just this little fish and this bread. What are you doing? Go back. You know, our Lord have no time for you. This is nothing to feed that crowd of people. And that is what many things, situation, and people try to tell us. Come on, what are you trying to do? You know, come on, who are you? Who are you? Not only the situations around you, but sometimes ourselves. Oh, who are you? What can you do? Look at yourself. Hey, you are an amazing person. You know, you are bought by the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. You belong to Him. You are amazingly made. You have gifts and things that nobody else has. You know, you are a pipe. You are, you know, a pipeline in the hands of a powerful God. And it's not all about you. It's about the mighty God that you have. It's not about you, sorry. It's not about you. It's not about Marcian, but it's Him. The glory, all the glory goes to Him. You are just a small tool that God does to show His love to this world. Amen. So, who are you? You are the son, the daughter of Christ. You belong. You are a princess, a prince. You in the hands of this mighty God, you can do tremendous thing. Allow yourself to dream. Allow it to stretch. I remember the Peter in the boat. Remember Peter on the boat? Jesus calling you, come on, Peter. Let's take a walk. Remember? The 11 people there on the boat. Oh. Huh? Peter was the only one that could tell to his grandchildren, oh, you know, one day, one day, Grandpa, he was there on the top of the water. But Grandpa did. The other 11 people, they thought, whoa, the water is secure. I will not step from the boat. But you know, if you want to walk on the waters, you have to step out of the boat. And you know, bad news. The boat is not always safe. Sometimes the boat sinks. You know, God called us to adventure. To walk in the waters, to take steps of faith. It's not all about you, but it's about the one that is calling in you. If he says go, it's done. We arrived there in Ethiopia with nothing. The government didn't give us any money. We have no money from the government, and we don't want, because come money with some strings attached. But they gave us land to build the project. We got land in Ethiopia, in two different places. From nothing. We had people helping us building, people that were not even believers. God used who he wants to use. One person passed there in a project, what are you doing? Say, well, we are starting a project for children here, and how can we help you? Say, government gave us land, but we have no money to build. Say, okay, I will help you. I will help you. Many people sometimes, this lady alone gave $40,000 to build. She was not a believer. She didn't know us. We didn't know her, but there is done. You have the courage. Move. Persevere. You don't see, but God spoke. He said, it's done. Amen. Take courage. Move forward. Sometimes, Leandro, I have here just fish and bread. What can I do with that? 5,000. Come to the front. And be willing to be discipled by the master. Imagine the disciples seeing this little boy with a few things and the big crowd. And Jesus, the Bible says that he knew what he was going to do. God knows. Are you willing to join him in an adventure? Jesus calls the disciples and come on, spread some bread around. And the disciples, they're both. This is real training, This is training on the job. The disciples experiencing, seeing the multiplication of the bread and the fish, and they are there, part of it. They are taking the things and giving to the people. They don't just watch, but they take part of it. Are you ready to take part? Are you ready to act? God call us for action. Amen. He call us for actions. We move. It's easy to tell other people or to complain to God. Is it, oh God, Or if, we have so many if. It's me. It's me and you. For us was being there, we were there in those countries for 7 years with our family in many different circumstances, in many different places. God wants to use our hands, our mouth, our legs. God wants to use us to hug somebody, to say, I love you. Those children there in India, they are untouchables. They are dirt, stink. In Africa, and God said, I love them as much as I love you. Do you think you are better than us? I want to embrace these children. I want to be close to. I want to drink a coffee with them, to eat their food. And we are there as church, as kingdom of God, to show the love of God to those places in need. I don't know where you are or your situation, in your neighborhood or somebody from your family, in your working place, or somewhere there outside in another part of the world. Remember Nehemiah? Nehemiah sees the suffering of his people. He suffers, he prays, and he goes before the king. And the king says, Nehemiah, something is wrong with you. And come the million question, the question of the king asked Nehemiah. Nehemiah, what can I do for you? What can I do for you? My brother, my sister, it will come time. You will remember this word this day, because it will come the time when God will put people and situations before you for your dream, for your vision, and they will ask you, what can I do for you? What can I do for you? But if you have no dream, no vision, if it's nothing there burning in your heart, why they will ask, what can I do for you? You understand? Isn't it? If there is not something there on the pipeline ready to... Why somebody would say, what can I do for you? What can God do for you today? Which kind of doors He can open for you today, for me today? What do you believe for it? What do we believe for it? But it's up to us to move. Up to us to be there, to take action. I remember the Good Samaritan. He was right there in the situation. Would the people pass it by? You remember the story of the Good Samaritan? A priest, a Levite. They pass it by. And the Good Samaritan had a compassion. Oh, he stopped it. He stopped it. He had compassion. He allowed himself to be moved by the compassion of God. You know, I'm 55 now. I'm 55. I'm still pretty young, isn't it? But life is so short. After the 50s, it looks like we begin to count backwards. You know, we begin to count how many times is still left for me. You know, the life is so short and there's so much there that God wants to move us together. There's so much there that God wants to use our hands to touch, to do it, to make it. The Samaritan guy, he stopped and he allowed the compassion of God to touch him. Some of the people, they look too busy. Oh, you know, so, I have my own thing I'm involved with. I'm a priest. This business of caring for dirty people, hurted people, it's not with me. It's not about other people, what other people do. We think, oh, they should do something about, it's about me. What should I do? The Samaritans those times didn't have a very good reputation. It's about me and my God. He stops. He allows himself to be moved by compassion. Remember Jesus and the guy with the leprosy? Jesus first have compassion. And he moved close to this guy with the leprosy and he touches him. And he heals him. The Samaritan is moved with compassion. He has allowed himself to be touched. And he takes this guy. And he doesn't wait for nobody's donkey. He put on the top of his own Cadillac. He opened the doors of his Cadillac and say, come on, hurt guy, get in. I need to take you somewhere. And he doesn't wait for nobody's medicine. He takes his own. Remember? It's his own. And he... I don't know, he had to deal with his wife later when he arrived home from market. Where do you have the shopping? Well, there was a guy on the street. It's what's on me today. What's on you? I don't know. What adventure God is calling you, calling us to be. I don't want to stop at 55. You know, I don't want to retire and be old and be on. Was John Pipe that he said, I don't want to be retired and collecting seashells on the seashore. Pouring. Amen. God has so much there for us. So much of His love He wants to demonstrate for us. So much training, discipleship on the job. Then experience on the job, multiplication, miracles, and it's happening there. And will happen through you and with you. Yeah. Amen. God has so much there for me and for you. And I believe He's calling us today to move forward. You know, get out of the comfort zone. Move forward. Enlarge, stretch, expand. Build a dream in your heart. Build, let something grow there in your heart. And build the supports for those things and be ready. Because I believe God has tremendous things for us to move forward. I want to ask you to stand up together, please. Let's stand up. What is your vision today? What is your dream? What's your ambition? You know, what are the things that are stopping you? What are the challenges? I know the challenges are there. I know. They are there. But my brother, my sister, you know, don't allow them to stop you. You are a beautiful princess, a powerful prince. You are a son and a daughter of Christ. You are empowered. Ask God to give you faith and grace. There are tremendous things God wants to do through you. Let's pray together. Father, we come as a church before you this morning. And Father, we want to commit ourselves to enter in this adventure with you. Take us together, Lord. We don't want to be just listeners, but we want to commit ourselves this morning to stretch our own possibilities and to walk on waters with you and to let you use our lives as tools to be a blessing. Father, we want to take the courage today to persevere on faith, believing on who we serve. And Father, move us today in action. Father, take us from our comfort zone. Father, kick us out today of our boat. And Father, I pray that you bother us out of our boat today. Give us the grace for the things that we don't have today, for the courage that we don't have today. Oh, give us courage and strength. Empower us by your power. And may all honor and glory be to your name. Because you are the author of our faith. May you be glorified through the miracles, through the things that you will do through our lives, through this church, through each one of us as individuals. May your name be glorified. We want to jump on adventure of faith together with you, Father. I pray this in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Shall we sing together? Shall we celebrate our Lord? We serve a mighty God. Amen. We serve a powerful God. No limit. No limit. I don't know how many children. We are only 1,000. We have 1,000 children, but no limit. I don't know how much God can do, and I don't know how much God will do on you and through you. No limits. Because He is limitless. He's powerful God, a merciful God, and loving God. And God looks at us with eyes of sympathy. Amen. Let's worship Him and celebrate Him this morning. Let's sing together. God bless you all. Amen.